Wally's ASMR world here. Hope we're all good. So it is Thursday. Yep, that's right, Thursday. Let's try and adjust this camera a little bit. I don't want the microphone full on view if we can help it. So today's video, I need. Wait. This is a bugger to try and get this thing just where you want it, really. Basically, today. So I didn't get my video done yesterday, which is Conspiracy Wednesday. So we are doing Conspiracy Thursday in a bit. I'll be recording that shortly. First, I want to do a shopping haul, so to speak. And I've also got to record out my Royal Rumble predictions and a Raw and SmackDown review. Hopefully I get that done today as well. Right then, so why didn't I get the video done yesterday? Okay, if you watch my channel regularly, you'll know that I had a litter of puppies recently, and unfortunately, one of the puppies, which was 6 days old, or 5 days old, sorry, passed away yesterday. It's a bit shit. So, kind of took up most of my day, and then today, about 5:30 this morning, I was burying the dog out the back, putting it in a little grave and marked it so we know where it's at for future reference. That's a bit horrible really, but that's the way it's been. So yesterday though, sorry not yesterday, a couple of days ago, which I won't just be able to do a video about it now. I'm too far back from the microphone, guys, hang on. Oh, everything that could go wrong is going wrong right now. Single lad or young when it got misses, it's not scary, it's a bit of fun. when you're a young man, early 30s, and you've got a 16-year-old daughter, and you've got a wife, and you've never done it before, it is worrying. But I'll go into that in another video. Yeah, like I said, the moaning of man. So what did I buy with my part of, well, some of my money? I'm going to show you. And this is what happens when you get to my age. You get some fun things, you get some not so fun things. So, hang on. So, I picked up a new Xbox One because I sold mine just before Christmas. Believe it or not, this is about the fifth Xbox One I've now had. But I can pass this up. It's a 1TB Xbox One. And I think it was £180 from CEX. I was going to buy brand new, what's the point in that? CEX, £180, 2 years warranty, you can't go wrong. So I got the Xbox One. I used to do Xbox videos on here, which some of you will know. But they were great because I had a crappy microphone. I've ordered the parts that I need so I can connect this microphone, the Blue Yeti, up to the Xbox One, and then we'll have proper good quality ASMR gaming videos. I can't wait. I'm really excited to do that. That's another avenue you can take the channel down, proper Xbox gaming ASMR videos with good quality sound. And you can watch me struggle on my games. And that is something I'll be bringing you over the next few months. Just video every now and again or whatever. What else was there to say? So yeah, I've ordered them parts for the Yeti. Oh, I got some games for the Xbox. Crash Bandicoot. This takes me back to my childhood. When I was a kid, I absolutely loved Crash Bandicoot. I got a PlayStation 1 about a year after they came out, and I had some money for Christmas. I was about 10 years old, I think, or 11, and I was desperate to go to town and get Crash Bandicoot 2, or Crash Bandicoot 1. I'm sure it was Crash Bandicoot 2 I had on the PlayStation 1, or maybe it was on PS2. I can't remember. I've had all three of them in the past. 1, 2, and 3. I just love them, and my wife does. So I bought this for us yesterday. That was £30. We went to town yesterday before that. We realised the puppy was unwell. He came on suddenly with the puppy, and he passed away last night. But during the day, we'd gone and done a bit of shopping. When we come back, we saw that he wasn't very well, or she wasn't very well. Sorry. It was all a bit of a shock. I got Titanfall. I don't know why, because once I logged into my Xbox account, I already had Titanfall 2 from my last Xbox, so I now have them both. But in all honesty, I prefer Titanfall 1, and that was only £1.50. Can't complain about that. Battlefield 4 advertisement inside. Battlefield 5 there, but that was like £35-40, and I've not played this enough yet. I had it when I had my Xbox before Christmas, but I didn't play nowhere near enough. And I got Mafia 3. I've completed Mafia 2, great game. I can't wait to play this one. This one's set in 1968 in Louisiana. Says that the rules of organised crime have changed. So I'm looking forward to playing that. Becoming a mafia hitman, or whatever really it's going to be in there. And my daughter's got like a stack of games for the Xbox One, which I'll be playing as well. She's got like the new Assassin's Creed for Christmas, and Farming Simulator. I've tried that, it's so difficult, and so bloody annoying. Right, what else did I get? So I can connect the Blue Yeti at the bottom there, just there. anti-aging daily moisturizer. 5 actions against signs of aging. Hopefully it works. Start using this in your early 20s. Don't wait to get to your early 30s. It's probably already too late for me. And that's that one. And that's what this series of videos is going to be about, the moaning of man. Just giving you bits of advice whilst you're young. Saying will probably resonate with you, but yeah, he's got a point there. And I love a good read. I've wanted this for a while, but I couldn't justify spending more than £3. Harry Redknapp. It shouldn't happen to a manager. He's managed a lot of football clubs over the years, and in this he tells you about stuff that he's seen in the change room about fights. He shares everything he's learned from a lifetime in the sport and the wisdom from greats like Cluffy and Ferguson. I'll tell you about what actually happens in the dressing room, the bust-ups behind the scenes, and the times when I had to swap an arm round a player's shoulder for a boot up the arse. It's my guide to being a manager, the Harry way. So yeah, we got that to read. Should be good. I have read Harry Redknapp's first autobiography this quite about a year ago. And other than clothes and the stuff, I bought one other thing, but I've not brought it with me, so hang on. When you get to my age, weight becomes an issue if you don't look after yourself. I've started to look after myself. I have a parcel coming today or tomorrow. Freestanding punch bag, you have a heavy base, so I'm gonna be working out on that. I might do an unboxing of that on here tomorrow or the day after. I've been doing weights, I went for a run last night down to the vets to get some medication for the dog. I had like 20 minutes to get there. It's a 20 minute walk each way. I had to leg it as fast as I could. I made it in like 8 minutes, I think. I was buggered. My legs are killing me now. I haven't run in about 4 years. But what we bought yesterday, I bought it yesterday to try and help me with my weight loss, was a meal replacement shake. So I bought this stuff in here. It is Slim Fast strawberry flavour. And that's what you're going to get here. With the moaning of man, you're going to get real life men's problems. And in real life, your real life man isn't ripped to shreds. He isn't Channing Tatum. He is me. I'm a real man who eats crap on a weekend and regrets it on a Sunday or a Monday, and then works out Monday to Friday just so they can eat and drink on a weekend and regret it all over again. So I bought this stuff. I haven't tried it yet, so let's give it a go. You just add 240 mils of milk to 2 scoops off the shake. It's all bloody lumpy at the bottom, which I'm peed off about. That's going to be nasty. That's really tasty. What, really tasty. It's just at the bottom. It's called stuck, which I need to sort out in a bit. The idea is you have one of them instead of a meal a day. And then you have a low-calorie meal later on in the day and a snack on fruit and exit, yeah, fruit and other healthy snacks throughout the day. Anyway, that's the video done, guys. That's my haul done. I wish I had my punch back here to show you. But it hasn't arrived yet. And I've also bought an ab roller as well, like a wheel on handles, and you roll it out and roll it back in, and it works your abs. So I ain't going to be no, like I said, no Brad Pitt or Channing Tatum anytime soon. I'm giving it a good go and getting myself fit whilst I'm young enough to do so. Especially when I go on holiday in July or August, I do not want to look like a beached whale compared to all the Geordie Sherlock who will be there, or the people who think they are like the Geordie Sherlock.